Begin like we always do, acknowledging we're on Treaty One land, the traditional homeland of the Métis. Good morning to all those that are here in person or watching via the live stream. I'll first just begin by asking for an adoption of the minutes of the previous meeting.
I'll move adoption of the minutes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thanks. Delegations.
We do have a request to appear in delegation. The committee would have to suspend the rules. Councillor Berwadi has requested to be heard with respect to item one of the infrastructure renewal and public works agenda of May 30th, 2017, and that's with respect to the motion on transit safety.
I move suspension to rules, Mr. Chair.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thanks. Welcome, Councillor. Morning. Welcome.
Good morning. Thank you very much. I'm just here in regards to item number one of the RPW agenda. This is a motion that came forward from myself and seconded by Councillor Lukes in regards to transit safety and security. I'd like to thank the many bus drivers, their union, ATU, under the leadership of John Callahan, our staff and management of transit, as well as my colleagues, some of them not on EPC, that have come up with some ideas and some concerns about dealing with transit safety and security. I'd be remiss if I didn't acknowledge that it was Councillor Mays last year that put some of this on the public agenda. I did some behind-the-scenes work last year on the file as well. Obviously, we're here because of the part of it is the recognition that assaults against drivers, our city employees, are not acceptable. There's signs in, I noticed in Toronto's city buses that there's almost a transit assault a day. That excludes verbal abuse against transit operators. And we've seen some many abuses here of drivers and passengers in Winnipeg, including the recent fatality in February. I'd like to thank the administration for their report. I understand that it was improved significantly after we came out with some of our recommendations, and that's absolutely positive. And very excited to see that there's going to be a transit advisory committee coming forward, something that most jurisdictions across Canada have, and that's very positive. I'd like to compliment the chair of IRPW, Councillor Lawrence, for his work on that file. At the last meeting, we asked the administration to provide verbal updates at every monthly meeting, and that was accepted as a friendly suggestion that that's going to happen, and I look forward to working with transit to see that TAC committee formed and the details around that, so that's very positive. So the recommendation that came out of committee May 30th in regards to the motion that was brought forward at the last council meeting was to simply lay the matter over until September. These are ideas that can be now sent to the TAC once it's formed, and this sort of puts it just sort of in a holding pattern until that time. So it would be my hope that EPC today could simply accept the Standing Policy Committee recommendation. This item does have to go forward to council, which I guess means next week. So I thank you.
Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Okay.
For the delegations registered, Your Worship.
Okay. Thanks very much. We'll move to EPC reports. First one is the Access Advisory Committee 2016 Annual Report. I'll just say a few words before Councillor, actually I'll let you introduce it first.
Oh, I'll introduce the report, Access Advisory Committee 2016 Annual Report, number one.
Thank you, Councillor. I just want to take this opportunity to acknowledge and thank the Access Advisory Committee. They've done some great work over the last year, and just want to commend them.
Yes, I concur, Mr. Mayor, and with that, I would simply move that we move this report forward.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Report two is appointment of fund manager for computer replacement reserve.
Oh, awesome.
Would you like to? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thanks. Audit committees?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, there's five items here, but I'll move them each separately. So for the first one, item number one, the quarterly report card 2017, quarter one, I'll move that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried.
For the second audit of the new fire paramedic station construction project status report 2017, quarter one, I'd be happy to move that.
Thank you, Councillor. And I'll just say my understanding is of the total 14 recommendations, 12 have been implemented already. I want to acknowledge and thank the work of our auditor and public service with the remaining two recommendations targeted for third quarter of this year. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried.
Number three is the Winnipeg Police Service Headquarters Construction Project Status Report 2017 Quarter 1 Report. I'd be happy to move that.
Thank you, Councillor. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Carried.
Number four is the Audit Department 2016 Annual Report. I will move that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Carried.
And finally, number five, the Audit of Procurement for the Pedestrian and Cycling Strategies Report and Review of the Employee Code of Conduct. I'll be happy to move that.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Carried. Okay, we'll move to committee reports. First up, innovation.
I'd like to move items 1 through 3 inclusive.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Carried. Thank you, Councillor. Next up is water, waste, waste bank management, and the environment.
Items 1 and 2 inclusive.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Carried. We'll move to Standing Policy Committee on Infrastructure Renewal and Public Works.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. With respect to item number one, I do want to thank Councillor Broady for his work on this file as well and bringing a number of different ideas forward.
Do you want to move? Do you want to do them individually?
Take that one or? 2, 3, 4.
We can pull some.
Let's pull one.
Okay.
1, 2, and 3.
Okay.
Let's vote on 4.
So, 4 and 5.
4 and 5. Yeah.
Okay, so we'll vote on 4 and 5 report. 4 is the agreement to allow city access to info with the province of Manitoba's advanced routing and permitting system. And report 5 is 2017 regional and local street renewal program. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Carry.
Okay. Thank you for your guidance. So with respect to the transit safety motion, there are some good ideas in there. The path that IRPW chose to take was to request a comprehensive transit safety report in the aftermath of the tragic event that took place this year. There was a great deal of work that went into that report. IRPW approved that report at our last meeting and moved it forward. That report does include, for the very first time, the establishment of a transit advisory committee. And, Mr. Mayor, I'm happy to report that I already have several meetings set up this week, in fact, with the administration and, in fact, Mr. Callahan to discuss the formulation of that committee. And that committee is really formulated for the purposes of dealing with safety issues. So what I'd like to do is have this motion receive this information. It doesn't mean that these ideas are being taken off the table at all. They are still live ideas, but they are ideas that can be certainly submitted by any councillor for consideration to the TAC at any time once it's formulated. So that would be my motion to receive this is information with the understanding that we do have a comprehensive report on transit safety that is, in my view, very proactive in addressing these very same issues.
I'd just like to thank you for your efforts, Councillor, in working collaboratively with the key stakeholders, including, of course, ATU. Our administration, especially Winnipeg Transit officials, as well as senior administrators, and do appreciate your ability to work collaboratively with everyone. And I also want to just acknowledge and thank all members of council who I know have been having dialogue with you, and I would just encourage us to continue working with you all the parties as collaboratively as possible on such an important issue. So that I think you've done some great work. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
Councillor Mason.
Yeah, to continue a bit on that theme, it is, having been here 5.5 years now and sort of seen this issue evolve a bit, it is good to see. I think we're all basically now committed to trying to do something. What that something is, we'll have to work out. Councillor Morant has certainly put in a lot of time on this. Councillor Broady was generous enough to thank me. I would point out Councillor Gilroy and Councillor Allard have done a lot of work in this term on this issue. I spoke at EPC budget considerations in early January of 2013 before I was on EPC, and I talked about adopting the staff report that called for 6 more positions, and that went nowhere. Luckily, I was able to get on EPC the next year, and I made it a priority, and we weren't able to pass that. But those 6 positions, none of them were ATU. They were WAPSO positions. They were inspectors. So I just want to note that we do have a number of stakeholders in this as well. WOPSO representing the inspectors, and of course the police union representing the police, who had issues with that report the way we formulated it in 2014 and some of the duties, and I spent an ungodly amount of time meeting with various different unions and seeing if we could try and work out who should be doing what. So I'm pleased to see Councilor Morantz now will have that same role of sitting down with various different stakeholders and trying to sort out, without getting running afoul of any of the three different unions that have some stake in this. So pleased to see us moving forward on this, and I know there's it's just heartening to see it isn't getting nasty, it isn't getting politicized, it isn't getting accusatory, and we can just keep moving forward and actually trying to do something.
We'll vote on it then. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. So to receive this info, report two is you pass program exemption.
Yeah, Mr. Mayor, with respect to this motion, just to give some history, of course I will be supporting moving this motion to budget consideration, which is, I think, a reasonable approach. The UPass program it actually stands for Universal Pass, not University Pass. The reason it's called Universal Pass is because the reason it works financially is because all students pay. And that was really a decision that was made through various referenda that were held at our university campuses. Those referenda said in the question that really anyone who lives within the city of Winnipeg would pay. After that happened, it is a new program, so at times different issues arise, and Councillor Mays did bring forward an issue saying, well, there are students that live in the city of Winnipeg that don't necessarily live in a transit service area. And so there should maybe some consideration for opt-outs in those situations. So the point of this motion is really to address that situation. And so by referring it to budget, we'll have an opportunity to debate that issue more thoroughly. So with that, I would move this number two UPass program exemption motion to budget.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Mason.
Yeah, thank you for some of that context. And to add to context, I'm all in favor of universality. And if someone were to leap up right now and say, we're going to extend handy transit all the way out, so everyone in the city will get handy transit, then I would say, fine, we are treating everyone equally when it comes to the transit service. Alas, in 2012, we had a report, October of 2012, we had a report from staff after I passed a motion asking for a study of this. And the motion said, no, we aren't going to extend the handy transit program out beyond the transit service area. And there was a very specific line drawn. There were 34,105. I may be a couple of people off there. 34,000 and some people who live outside the transit service area. There was a hard line drawn. If you're outside that, alas, you do not get handy transit, because the handy transit program is a mirror of regular transit. So to reiterate that, there was not universality, unfortunately, when it came to handy transit. There were 34,000 unlucky souls within the city of Winnipeg boundaries, many of them south of the perimeter in my ward, who could not get handy transit because they were outside the transit service area. Now, to fast forward to present day, we seem to have erased that line when it comes, however, and we've decided everyone's all in and we're all universal when it comes to the UPass program. Understandably, some people in my ward question that, saying, well, wait a minute, if we aren't all in on handy transit, if there's a transit area with a hard line for one program, surely that should apply to another program. I think a very fair point. We'll run this through. Also a very fair point to say, fight it out in the budget. That's what we'll do. Certainly, when I've talked to people south of the perimeter, I think some of them would actually opt in, so we would make it an opt-in provision. This doesn't apply only to my ward. Councilor Dobson, for example, has some people just west of the perimeter. But this is the incongruity that you get people outside the perimeter who are still inside the city boundaries. If you're in St. Norbert and you're in that situation, no problem. You get pretty good transit service. If, however, you're in the Dobson part or in my part, south of the perimeter, but inside the city, you get no regular transit. You get no handy transit. But as I pointed out, you have the very complex situation. We have exemptions in the UPass program now. If you live outside the city boundaries, you're exempt. If you can get on handy transit, you're exempt. Some rational exemptions from the universality. So what I'm saying is there should be another exemption. What, for example, happens to you if you are a disabled student living south of the perimeter in my ward? Are you exempt because you can get handy transit? But no, you can't get handy transit because you can see the the incongruity that comes up. So my thanks to a lengthy negotiation to come up with the wording. My thanks to the mayor's office and Councilor Moretz. So I would support referring it on, and we'll see what comes of the budget.
Okay. Call the question then. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Thanks. Next is Report 3, review of reduced speed school zones bylaw.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. With respect to this item, I think what I would recommend is there seems to be perhaps some lack of clarity as to why the program was implemented in the way it was implemented in the first place, which was Monday to Friday. A lot of the discussion surrounds, well, really, you know, some holidays children are in school, some holidays children are not in school, and that can lead to a lot of confusion among drivers. So simply just to post a sign that says, well, it doesn't apply on holidays, might not really be accurate. So because of that lack of clarity, I think what I'd like to see done with respect to this is for a motion, which I'll make, for us to refer this motion back to the public service for a report on the rationale for why the school zones have been implemented in the way they are, and that report would come back to IRPW.
Yep. Okay. Do you want to specify a time frame to report back?
Not really, no. That's okay. I'll follow up with them.
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Carried. Thanks. Motion to adjourn.
All with consent and adjournment.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thanks. Aye. Have a great day, everyone.